Hello guys and welcome to the Beyond Sana channel. My name is Shanks and today we are gonna play 1v7 against 7 Heart Armies in BFME 1 on the patch 1.06, but this time without the castle. We are playing on the map Rune and we have only camps in this one. For the first video we're gonna choose the Rohan faction, but if this video gets 150 likes... Oh hey SpongeBob. We can also do that also with Gonzo, Isengard and even Mordor. That's gonna be a tough one. Trust me on that one. Alright, we're gonna start with two farms inside the base and also recruit the Hobbit Merry immediately. It looks like we are at the top left spot this time, okay? And we already see one Eye of Sauron, that means we have at least, at bare minimum, one Mordor opponent. And actually for this one, I'm gonna skip making these peasants because I believe they are not gonna add too much to the table. They have only 80 command points as you can see, so I'm not gonna waste 10 of my command points for really weak units like peasants. We can make even one more farm, shall we? Buy this farm as soon as possible. And then we're gonna grab this farm right after. And the real challenge in this one would be definitely to try to win the game with heroes exclusively. Even though I believe that this is gonna be nearly impossible. You know, hard is easy, impossible is gonna take some time. So let's try it, just why not? If we fail, we fail. Quickly. Gonna buy more farms. I'm gonna fill up the base with farms exclusively, guys, first of all, because I wanna get Legolas on the field first. The Prince of the Midwood Elves himself. Merry is gonna be nice early on because, you know, with Merry, we can always grab the settlements and also use them as a way of protection for the farms early on. Buy this farm. There we go. Uh-oh, Uruk-hai. These are Uruk-hai. Their shields are sick and they are... Uh-oh, crossbowmen as well, what's going on? We need to make some towers. You win! Hello darkness, my old friend. Oh, this is our early attack actually, guys, not gonna lie. We need some more towers because those Uruk-hai are not orcs. We're gonna lose the farm immediately. That's unfortunate that we are facing against Isengard, because Isengard has the most aggressive playstyle from all the factions in BFME1. We have to get our hobbits back in the business. Buy the last farm here and make some more towers, shall we? We can maybe beat this crossbowman inside the towers and make them follow up the hobbit. Then we can just cloak him, just like that. Alright, now you see him, now you don't. Okay. He was even buying this mill offensively, dude, that's unfortunate. The thing is, Legolas is a nice hero, yes, but he has no damage against buildings. I mean, we can use a knife fight, I'm assuming. We can beat this Uruk-hai. Okay. Get invisible just like that. I'm actually scared, guys. I'm actually scared. Can we do it, though? That's the question. We're gonna use the swords to kill the workers, at least, so we deal at least some damage. The plan is simple. We're gonna get the monster trio on the field. Legolas, Aragorn, and Gimli. Side by side. Kill these workers. I didn't even know. I learned something about this game. Because the Eye of Sauron, did you guys see that? It was giving leadership to this. Oh, we see Gollum here. Gollum against Merry, the show match. By the way, we are also using the HD edition from BFME1. And you can also download BFME1 on your PC. There is gonna be a link in the description down below of the video. How is this Gollum winning against my Merry like this? It was a really close fight. Normally, Hobbit is way stronger. But I'm assuming because we are... Oh, he's using Eye of Sauron to reveal my Hobbit. But because we are pacing against Heart Army, I'm assuming... Can I get cloaked? Yes, I can. Nice. Okay, we were able to save the day. And Legolas, guys, the Prince of the Midwood Elves, is on his way. And we have also heal available in the worst case. Before we're gonna go for Aragorn and Gimli, I would like to get also... Look, this farm is going down in a second. Use Hawkstrike. Can we save it? The answer is no, we cannot save it. Oh, it is how it is. Before we're gonna get Aragorn and Gimli, the Son of Glóin, on the field, we need to get Éomer first, guys. I think the reason why we're gonna get Éomer first on the field is because of the outlaw leadership we get. Once he's level 2. It means we get money every time we kill enemy units. Which is gonna, you know, be very efficient in this one because we're gonna kill thousands of units. Let's go for a well here. And after Éomer, the next hero on the list is gonna be Aragorn. That's why we need to get the draft now, which is gonna lead us later on to the Anduril Sword from the Spellbook of Rohan. I mean, Legolas is a very strong hero. in those kind of situations. As long as they don't have siege weapons, we should be fine. And now I'm gonna show you something which is called passive leadership. So I'm gonna use Hawkstrike Guys of Legolas. Let's put Eomir next to Legolas though. Let's go like this. We can share experience, as you can see. What are they attacking? Are they attacking my hobbit or something? I don't know. And Eomir is level 2 already. Now we can also use... Oh, during all this time, our second farm is getting attacked. We're gonna use Knife Fighter from Le... Okay. Berserker is here. Alright. You remember this scene when Aragorn was screaming, "Kill him! Kill him!" You know? As the Berserker was about to bump the... Helm's Deep Wall in the movies. Legolas, how about attacking with the knife? He looks so cool with the Knife Fighter. We gotta see for Aragorn first. Okay, we killed this one. Let's just peel back. The only thing I don't like about Knife Fighter is you need to wait until the duration is gone before you can use your bow again. That's something I don't like to see that much. Now we have enough power points for the Anduril Sword and almost the money we need also for Aragorn. Okay, I mean, the thing is, in this one, guys, in this mod, which is Rune, we don't have walls, so we're gonna get attacked and they don't need siege weapons to deal with us, you know? Of course, we have a couple of sentry towers, but they are not only way weaker than the big towers from the castle, but they are also getting destroyed quite easily from our opponent. Okay, Aragorn is gonna be on the field very soon, and the next one on the list is going to be Gimli. And once we get Gimli on the field, we're gonna have to make some units as well, in order to be able to destroy the enemy base. Okay, let's face... Aragorn is quite tanky now with the Anduril Sword plus the Blademaster. And we have almost the money we need for our Gimli as well. Like 1,000 more and we are good to go. Okay. Let's use Elendil, shall we? Go back to the shadow! Aragorn is very strong, very, very strong. Like... Oh, we lost this one actually. Put Eomir next to this Legolas, so he gets level 4, which is gonna unlock his leadership for the horses, for Rohirrim and Rohirrim Marches later on. Let's use also Blademaster. This way he becomes more tanky also. Anduril Sword gives you 50% armor, but so does the Blademaster as well. The Aragorn is not gonna only hit like a truck, but he's also gonna be tanky as a truck. Okay. They are also dealing way too much damage to the towers though, this Uruk-hai. As Gimli would like to say, these are not orcs, these are Uruk-hai. Their shields are fake and their armor broad. Okay. I mean, we have Atalas in heal, so I'm not too much worried about this situation. Gimli next, so we can put him next to Aragorn. Aragorn has splash damage as well, so he's able to hit multiple units at the same time. You can see we are killing 3 units with 1 strike. Aragorn is a one-man army for sure. Especially when he gets level 10. That's gonna be the time for Aragorn to shine. And he's also faster, because Anduril Sword gives you also 25% more speed. So let's demolish the farm with level 2. Don't demolish your level 3 farms for the armory. We can also use... Oh, there is Saruman, alright, I see you, Saruman. Don't use Fireball on me, please. Better experience if you can. Look, Aragorn's damage. Uh-oh, wait. Don't attack him. Gimli is the one who gets the last hits. That's huge. That's huge. He's going for the stonework. Okay. Use leap attack maybe, Gimli? I can't use the leap attack on the river. Okay, didn't know that. They will learn. Armory is almost up. We need to kill the units first. But we have enough power points now for the Cloudbreak. We can also use Cloudbreak. The thing is, I want to get to the AOD summon as soon as possible. And the easiest way to do that is just go for the Cloudbreak now. And then for AOD next. Lords! Lords, what are you doing, my friend? This is not gonna work out for you. Okay, Aragorn is level 8. Once he's level 10, we get the chance to use AOD summon from Aragorn as well, which summons one battalion of the Army of the Dead. And Gimli is level 6. Level 7 is gonna unlock the Slayer. Uh-oh. Okay, we have level 8 Eomir as well. Spear throw deals actually a lot of damage, plus 30 for killing this ballista. Okay. Unfortunately, we're gonna lose this one, which is fine, I'm assuming. It's not a big deal. Oh, explosive mine, I see you, explosive mine. No. Not this time. Aragorn is hitting so hard. Let me kill this one, though. Let's peel back now. Keep your senses alert now. Kill this, please, Gimli. Okay, nice. We killed it. Let's peel back. We don't have to waste our heal. We have also Theoden on the fields now. Theoden, we can put him next to Legolas as well. Where is Legolas? He's around this side. Okay. Ideally, we want to get Theoden to level 4 as well, guys. Oh, trebuchets. We lost also Merry for some reason. I don't even know why. We gotta kill these trebuchets, guys. We gotta kill those trebuchets. Look, the Rohan heroes are dealing 0 damage, but when Aragorn is there, it's a different story. Aragorn is dealing so much damage, this is unbelievable. Level 8, almost level 9. Legolas is level 8, Eomir is level 8, Gimli is level 6, so we are, our heroes are pretty strong right now. We have everyone beside Eowyn, we don't need Eowyn now. The thing is, it's so hard to keep Eowyn alive since she's so squishy, you know? She's like a glass cannon. She's only good in some certain situations, and when it comes to deal with a Nazgul or with the Witch King himself, then she's gonna be good. But other than that, she's gonna be very weak. Okay, all the upgrades purchased, right? Yeah. Okay, next one on the list for the building is gonna be archer range, guys. Witch, is this Nazgul? Look, Legolas damage now with Talks, right? Boom! Legolas. The guy who hits very hard. Okay, I'm gonna do actually something now. We're gonna try to defeat one of the opponents with the heroes exclusively, shall we? Okay, we need to make 2 archers, I believe, to get the archer range to level 2, which is gonna give us the chance to recruit either Elven Warriors or purchase the Fire Arrow upgrade from the level 2 archer range, okay? We need Fire Arrow later on for the Rohirrim archers. Okay, now we're gonna go actually for the attack and try to defeat this opponent right there. And we have almost the power points for Army of the Dead anyway, so we should... Oh, this is hard, hitting very hard. Kill this, please. Okay, we don't need to use the... Right, let's use Arrow Winds with Legolas. Gimli can use Leap Attack. There we go. We get also so much money. That's tribute, but Aragorn doesn't care. Aragorn does not care. Oh, Eomir died. What is this damage from tribute, though? Dude! Okay, level 7. We lost 2 heroes, though, just like that. That's very unfortunate. The Rohan heroes are made of paper, I'm assuming. Archer range is level 2. Look at these trebuchets. This is so hard. And Aragorn is not doing anything for some reason. Oh, look at the damage. If Attila, so I'm not too much worried about this. Let's please go. Run for your life, Gimli. Please, 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 please. Don't die to Pippin, I'm telling you. Okay, we need to be careful also with Aragorn. Run for our lives, shall we? I mean, we have Attilas, so we can use Attilas, I believe, right? Okay, but ballistas are coming. We have AOD, we might need to use it. Even though I would like to get away without using it. Please run to the well, so you can sustain over time. And now we are going for the stable, guys. I don't know, Theoden is how many level? 2 levels. I mean, he's rank 2, that's what I'm trying to say. We need to get him rank 4 though for the Glorious Charge, that's very important. Heal up a little bit, we have Attilas on cooldown, heal is on cooldown. We have to kill these ballistas no matter what. Okay, we're gonna kill one of them with the Gimli and one of them with Aragorn, and while Legolas is gonna be the unit killer in this trio, the monster trio of Middle-earth. We have enough power points now for Army of the Dead summon. Let's make some Rohirrim archers, shall we? Theoden is back in the business already, and we're gonna wait wait a second. I'm curious about the damage from Legolas against the mine. Okay, level 9 Legolas, almost level 10 Aragorn. Okay, we have all the important heroes now back in the business. Let's try to kill this trebuchet, shall we? And we're gonna try to get our Theoden also level 4, very important. Unlock the Glorious Judge, which is the best spot for London Knights, Rohirrim and Rohirrim Archers. Superman jump by Gimli, kaboom! Just like that, I like it, beautiful. And we have Rohirrim Archers now on the field, we can purchase all the upgrades we were able to buy before. Aragorn is level 10. Okay, now we have a one-man army for sure. And what I'm trying to say, I'm gonna show you guys, okay? You go with Aragorn, use Army of the Dead summon. Make sure that Army of the Dead is the thing which tanks everything. Kill the Ballistas. We're not gonna make the same mistake with this heroes. Aragorn can 1v1 him, no big deal. Aragorn is dealing so much damage. Even to Treebeard, so Treebeard is gone. We have seen what happens when you don't kill Treebeard fast enough. He one-shots our heroes like Theoden and Eomer. Kill these catapults, kill this ballista. The siege weapons, they deal so much damage to units as well, if you don't know. Aragorn is face tanking the damage, so it's not a big deal. And let's kill the Citta first, shall we? Oh, there is more. Actually, we can summon maybe the Elven allies for this one. When it comes to deal with the siege weapons or buildings, you always want to make sure to use the sword mods from these units. Oh, Tyrion's dead though. I didn't pay attention. Aragorn, you need to use Atelas to save Eomer. Okay, we need to peel back now. We need to peel back because for some reason the towers are attacking our Eomer. We might need to use heal, yeah. I mean, we can keep going with Aragorn and Gimli, I'm assuming. Legolas and Eomer is gonna be staying behind while our Legolas is gonna deal. Oh. Okay, we're gonna use Slayer. We need to kill these trebuchets and ballistas. Aragorn, in the meantime, is doing his work. Okay. Kill the trebuchets first if you can make the choice. Because they are dealing way more damage than ballistas, if you don't know. Oh, okay, now run for your life. Hopefully, Slayer. Are we gonna die now to this tower? No way, right? Not even close, baby. Okay, now we need to run also with Aragorn. Okay, we have Rohirrim matches now on the field, which is good. We need to revive our Theoden and also get mounted with Eomer for the sports so we can make our units stronger. Okay? Okay, let's go like this. Kill this ballista first. With fire upgrades, we are dealing also damage to the buildings and siege weapons, which is very nice. And they have no armor leadership right now, that's why I'm not using the Veg formation. Okay, we need to peel back now. Healing up with these units. Get some more from these units on the field. Use Legolas to deal with these units around this side. Heal up a little bit with the Rohirrim and Rohirrim archers. I mean, Rohirrim archers. We have only Rohirrim archers so far. No Rohirrim. We don't need them. Okay. And now we need to kill this trebuchet next, shall we? We gotta wait for Theoden. He's gonna be back soon, very soon on the field. Alright. Leadership is very important in those kind of situations, guys. This way we can, you know, look how tanky this Gimli is. We are dealing zero damage to Gimli, that's unbelievable. Even with Eomer leadership. Alright, Legolas, kill your friends Gimli, please. Okay, that's good. Our Theoden is back in the, on the field, which is needed in order to be able to make our Rohirrim archers stronger. Let's go like this now. Get Theoden mounted, of course. So, guys, if he would attack the explosive mine with the Rohirrim archers, it would be boom and we would lose every hero to one shot. Explosive mine has crazy damage. Crazy damage. The siege weapon spam is annoying, to be honest with you. It's really annoying. Now we can use the trio to deal with these sides of the map, okay? While we are using the Rohan units. Rohirrim archers and Rohan here. Okay, be careful. Gotta use this Rohirrim to actually make this boom. There we go. You see what I mean? Theoden is almost level 4. Gotta kill. Put Theoden close to the units when you are killing stuff. This way you can share experience. And potentially hit level 4. You see where I put the Theoden at? It's always close to the units. This way we can... Look, ballistas and trebuchets all around the place. That's so annoying. That's so annoying. Okay, let's use Cloudbreak, shall we? And commit against this one in melee range. In close range, we need to use heal potentially here. Kill this next. And kill this ballista as well. And now we can kill the towers. Theoden is level 4 now for death and glory. And now we gotta try to defeat this Isengard player. Before the catapults are gonna demolish everything from us. We gotta kill the Citta first. Very important. So he can't not make any more buildings during this time. And it's down. And I believe we need to disengage now a little bit. Before we're gonna lose a lot of Rohirrim archers. Oh, we lost one. We lost one. We almost lost two even. That's unfortunate. But we are good now. We are good. In the meantime, our heroes are on this side. We are able to deal with this unit. So we can actually now move forward and try to take down this outpost next. And recover a little bit with the units, and then go back right after. We're gonna try to defeat this Isengard without the use of the Army of the Dead. Treebeard shouldn't be able to do much in those kind of situations. He's gonna burn very, very fast. And fire is his biggest weakness. He's dying very fast, as you can see. And we get 450 for killing the daddy of the forest of Fangorn. Please. Look what I'm gonna do now. Oh. Okay, I see you. You see Rohirrim now? This is from Gondor, by the way. He was summoning Rohan allies. He's trying to beat us with our own weapons. As we are able to destroy this outpost. We gotta kill this trebuchet. We can ignore everything else, because trebuchet is the biggest weakness. Kill Faramir next, if he can. Faramir is gonna die quite fast as well. And then Ballista is gonna be our next target. Siege weapons are so annoying to deal with, that's unbelievable. And they are spamming ballistas and catapults all around the place. I mean, we have seen also Rohan, because remember there was a... there was Gimli before on the field. We killed Gimli, so that means there is a Rohan opponent on the field, definitely. Who's attacking this? Uruk-hai, okay. Oh, there is one more ballista. Right, so we are one-shotting everything now because we have highly levels on our Rohirrim archers as well. The thing is, we cannot make any more units. We gotta cover this Elven Wood there from our opponent, so we have leadership back. If we are gonna fight on the Elven Wood from our opponent, we have no leadership, if you don't know. We can ignore these weak units and actually focus down the buildings. Glorious charges back up, yet let's use it, shall we? And just try to kill these buildings as soon as possible. He was remaking the Citta, by the way. But it's not a big deal, we should be almost able to one-shot this building at this point of the game. Let's kill this explosive mine before he reaches our base. He can actually destroy everything in a second. We need to use heal here. Alright, we need to hit and run all the time. We cannot finish this base, unfortunately, just yet. But what we can potentially do is we can maybe move forwards now with this unit around this side, alright? We can make one more unit. Our base is in a safe spot because our farms now are all level 3. That's gonna make them quite tanky. Okay. Oh, he has a lot of berserkers on the field, but they shouldn't be able to do much against this much damage. Alright, so let's heal up a little bit. There is even a Merry, or Pippin, sorry. Let's go for a trample. There we go. We are command points capped, that's the problem. We are not able to make any more units. Look how many ballistas! Dude, don't do that to me! Beat with the horses, I mean with the heroes. Now we can trample the soldiers, no big deal. That's a nightmare. I really don't want to use AOD, but I might have to. I might have to. Oh, look, even ants, siege weapons all around the place. I'm a man of my word. I'm gonna try to win this against Isengard at least without the EOD. Oh, what is my Legolas doing? Look, the siege weapons are around this side. It's crazy. Let's heal up. We have now one more unit on the field. And you gotta use Atialas potentially. Use this unit to kill the Ballistas. There we go. What are we waiting for? And then kill this with the Bleedmaster, shall we? Look, damage from Aragorn. Gotta be careful to not lose our units around this side. And always keep an eye on your heroes at the bottom side of your screen. Very important. Use Slayer. Try to kill the siege works very fast. Shall we? Oh, be careful with the heroes. We have all the power points collected now, which is quite nice. There is a Legolas as well on the field. See you, Legolas. Now you see him. Now you don't. It's the power of the Rohirrim Archers. Rohirrim Archers are one of the few units in the game which are actually strong against heroes, guys. Oh, you have Ents. And you have Aragorn. Alright, I see you. I've also Ents, my friend. Do you think you are the only one who can get Ents on the field? I don't think so. Let's try to focus down the building, shall we? Kill this Citta. Oh, look how fast our ants are going down. Let's kill this Uruk-pit. We were able to destroy this outpost. let's use heal. Heal Lords next. Lords, die please. There we go. And now peel back again. We dealt decent amount of damage, but our end surprisingly died very quickly. Like extremely fast. I think we can make one more units now. And make a well here, so we have double sustain and a farm. We don't need money right now. I believe we have good money. Oh, kill the explosive mine very fast before he reaches the site. There we go. Nice. We can fight here, not a big deal, because here we will be regenerating over time, even when we are fighting. And let's try to kill this beast with the heroes, with the monster trio. Legolas level 10, Aragorn level 10, and Gimli is level 8. Let's use Slayer to kill this Katar. And then we're gonna use Aragorn actually to use not only the Army of the Dead here, but also to use Blademaster and go and kill the Citadel. Oh! But during all this time, Glorious Charge is on cooldown. We need to kill this Katar very, very quickly. Kill the Katar, please. Alright. Aragorn is murdered. Oh, kill this mine, please, 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 please. Look this monster trio from the opponent. The good thing is we are recovering over time. We need to use Glorious Charge here. For Death and Glory, kill Aragorn as well if you can. Aragorn is down, that's good. Kill this trebuchet next. Oh, Aragorn, I was not paying attention. Legolas, revenge your friend and save Gimli, very important. Revive Aragorn now. Kill this. Right, recover over time. And Gimli. Oh, okay. I thought for a second we're gonna lose also Gimli. What's this damage, man? From this Elven unit. Oh, we lost the highly leveled Rohirrim Archer. Dude, I'm really trying my best to win this without AOD, but I think it's gonna be nearly impossible, guys. It's gonna be nearly impossible. Now we have Treebeard back in the business as well. What is going on here? Kill Treebeard, please, soon, fast. But our units are dying so fast. We must defend our country. This is the end. We need to kill Treebeard. Before anything else. Gimli. Legolas died also. And okay, we need to use AOD. We need to use AOD, guys. We need to save this base, really. We have to. I mean, I'm still holding my word. We are not defeating Isengard. Gimli died also? Are you kidding me? And now we're gonna lose his outpost. Dude! Oh no. AOD, please move forward and kill everything. If you don't mind. We lost all the heroes beside Eomir, guys. That's horrible. Okay, so we need to make a, oh, I don't know what to say. So unfortunate. Oh! Oh, Eagle Summon! From our opening as well. Oh, this is Fiesta. This is absolute clown Fiesta. He's killing our towers. Please, kill this. Exactly. Sorry. Okay, I mean, I don't know what to say. We are in a really bad spot. And you can see, it's way harder than it looks like. We need to use Elven Allies here to catch those tower guards. Trebuchets. If I can use, of course. Alright, now we can place them right there so we have additional leadership. Use the sword mod before they kill everything of us. Kill these trebuchets in melee range, shall we? Uh-oh, don't lose Eomir. Eomir is very important, we gotta keep him alive. Saruman is also around this side. Many units. Go for a trample. In those kind of situations, we can trample. Gildan is back first, that's good. We have leadership now. More leadership right now, that's good. Legolas is also back in the business. Legolas can also level up this Rohirrim matches, by the way, guys. And Theoden as well. Now we can level them up multiple times, which is quite nice. Okay. Now the monster tree is almost back in the business. We are waiting for Gimli, and Gimli actually takes more time to be revived. Because I was reviving them at the same time, pretty much, right? Okay, let's make triple farms here. And actually, he was not destroying this outpost for whatever reason. I'm fine with that. Oh, trebuchets. These trebuchets are annoying as hell. Okay, right. We are safe now. We need to hurry up now. We gotta use the monster tree once again to send them to this side of the map. Yes, we are losing the well, but it is how it is. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna recover and go for the attack. I mean, now we have highly leveled Rohirrim mages. We have even one of them level 10. Kill this Eomir first to get one-shotted. There we go. The good thing about Eomir is he makes us get so much money. I mean, that's really good. But he used Rain now, and Rain is nullifying all the leadership, and that's not good at all. With Glorious Charge, shall we? We're gonna focus down the buildings exclusively, pretty much. We gotta kill the Titter first, and then we're gonna peel back once again. We gotta watch out for the siege weapons, important. Kill the Titter, put him behind so he's not able to recover. Maybe we can even use Ents here, would be nice. There we go. Legolas is quite low again. I don't know what Legolas is doing. Why are you not attacking these guys, dude? Please, attack. What are we waiting for? Punish these enemies of Rohan. To Lord and right, Gimli's level 9. That's good. Wait a moment. We can fight here. I'm not too much worried about this situation. We can literally fight here. But you can see we didn't even defeat one player just yet, guys. This is insanity. This is insanity. Oh, the ants are... I forgot about the ants, to be honest with you. Right, let's kill this level 3 furnace, shall we? Kill this ballista. Make a well here. Stitch here in the backside, shall we? Okay, so we can put them next to each other, that's fine. And now, let's move forward. Our leadership is almost back up. Rain is such a great counter to these factions like Rohan and Mordor, because these factions are relying so much on the leadership, and Rain is negating all of that stuff. With Glorious Charge, kill the buildings. Okay. Kill Tribute next, very important. Also this Trebuchet. The Tribute should die very quickly, and I'm sorry, but I have to use AOD, otherwise this is gonna be a never-ending story. Look how fast we are losing the units, that's unbelievable. Kill the Titter, kill the units around this side. Kill up a little bit. Oh my god, I was almost one-shotting this. Please attack. Okay, we lost so much. That's unbelievable. Okay, kill the Titter, please. I don't know if you can, but it would be nice if you can. Alright, not many. Legolas is quite slow. Let's put him behind. He was face tanking this Trebuchet's damage for no reason. And now let's try to finish this piece, ASAP, as soon as possible. But there are eagles as well we need to kill first. This is unbelievable. Okay, let's go. We can leave this eagle, not a big deal. He's gonna die to the towers anyway, so I'm fine with that. Okay. Now is the time for us to defeat this. We need to catch this mine before it reaches our side. Do we have Glorious Charge? Almost. But I think we don't need to use it because there is only one tower remaining on the field. And after killing this one, the first opponent is gonna be defeated. I believe, right? No, here's an outpost. Here's an outpost, so he didn't get defeated. Use Glorious Charge here, shall we? Don't lose Eomir. Don't lose heroes like Aragorn. Gimli, please, be careful. Buy this. It's good. We have some reinforcements now around this area as well. Bring them to this side. Make a well. Make two wells actually here. So we can regenerate faster. Make farms. And our monster trio is still remaining on the field. That's good. We have one more Isengard around this side, but it's fine. It's not fine. Abort mission. Kill this mine. Kill this mine, please. Don't attack this mine. Don't attack this mine, okay? With your... he placed the bomb, right? Okay, he placed the bomb. Attacking that is the worst case scenario, by the way. Did they use Rain again? The answer is yes, they used Rain again. So we have, again, no leadership. Remember, they have multiple Isengards, right? So they will use Rain over and over again. Where is Legolas at? I put him accidentally inside the outpost. Okay. We need to use Glorious Charge, but I can't make more units around this side, shall we? And bring them also to this area. Oh, look, we are losing them so fast. There are just too many units to deal with. The Glorious Charge is still on cooldown. I'm gonna use Heal here to heal them up a little bit faster. In the meantime, Aragorn can use AOD maybe. Have to watch over many, many things. Oh, now the Rohirrim are coming from the open end. Glorious Charge, if you can. There we go. At least kill this one. In the meantime, use this. Legolas has to deal with the Nazguls. Okay. Legolas, please kill the Nazguls from Mordor. Very important. Aragorn can use Atelas. Gimli has to be careful as well. And we were able to survive for now. That's good. That's good. This area is protected. We gotta keep an eye on our heroes though. Legolas, kill this Nazgul please as well. Very important. Legolas can kill them quite fast. Look how the damage from Legolas. When he attacks this Nazgul, for some reason he stops attacking him. This guy wanna drive me crazy. Okay, we are waiting for the leadership to be back. Aragorn is still good. Trust me. He's not weak. Oh, we lost Eomer. We lost Eomer, unfortunately. Aragorn has to be careful now. Where is Gimli at? He's taking down this slaughterhouse. But it's fine. We can now retreat. We don't need to risk the biscuit, right? Look, I think that was an explosive mine. Look, they're supposed to be like this wood walls, you know? Kill this guy. Kill this trebuchet right after. Very important to kill these buildings. Uh-oh, that hurts. It hurts, that hurts, that hurts. Okay. That is siege work, so we can now keep going. And that is also tribute. We have no leadership right now. Okay, we're gonna be able to deal with him, no big deal. Kill this explosive mine, very important. And finish off this Mordovi, shall we? Okay, we are waiting for Eomer to come back, and then we are in good spot, I guess. Again, we didn't defeat anyone just yet. It's unbelievable, but it is how it is. And now, what we can do is we can use Cloudbreak and Elven Allies summon. Our Glorious Charge is back, and let's try to destroy this outpost, shall we? At least break the siege works. Yes, triple siege works. No wonder he was spamming mines and ballistas all the time. It was kind of unbelievable. Okay, this base has been defeated. I think that's the Heart Army, the Mordor, we were just able to defeat. Kill this Theorian, shall we? Should be dying in a second, even though without leadership, but we have level 10 Rohirrim archers. They're hitting very hard regardless. Kill the siege works. We can use also King's Favor here and kill Eomer at the same time. Eomer should also die in a second, as you can see yourself. There is one thing attacking. Okay. But it's fine, I'm just gonna ignore the fact. Save the level 10 if you can. Oh, there are eagles on the field, unfortunately for us. Come on, Tyrion. Okay, this outpost got destroyed as well. Right, we had to use heal to save our Tyrion, very important. Eomer is back in the business, so we can send him to this side as well. And our leadership should be back very soon. The monster trio was soloing this base very nicely. Now we can buy this farm. We lost this outpost for some reason. I don't even know what killed this outpost. We can kill Aragorn also, no big deal. Where is Eomer? Okay, there he is. And Aragorn is very strong, but he's not strong enough against this many Rohirrim archers at the same time. Okay. We could buy this farm back. Buy also this farm back. Make farms here just to not run out of money any soon. Make also towers, shall we? I'm losing my heroes very often because... Oh, AOD summon!
Don't let your kids watch it!
Yeah, but what you can, I can do that as well, AOD. I summon to fulfill your destiny. Fight for me. What say you? You need to save the space. That's what I'm saying to you. We lost everyone. We lost also Eomer, Theoden, everything, you know? Okay, move downstairs there. Luckily, we have a lot of money to revive our heroes over and over again. There is a Witch King from Engmar. I see you, Witch King of Engmar. Raising the banner of Rohan. Oh, look at this trebuchet spam. This guy's leaming, next level. And that's the first time I see them using EOD summon. Normally they don't do that. But this one is actually much more challenging. I gotta be honest with you guys. Now we're not gonna lose any time, but we're gonna move actually. We need to kill this guy first there. Very important. We can use the Rohirrim Arches to try to save the space. We have also Ant summon, so we can summon the Ants now. And break this Siege Warwick, shall we? And also break this Citadel. Okay. Monster Trio in the meantime. Okay, Legolas was just soloing this guy, no big deal. Aragorn can use AOD around this side. AOD summon. You kill this and you kill this Gimli, okay? Look, without leadership, you see Rohirrim Arches are not dealing too much damage. Alright, we gotta go back. There is the explosive mine, we gotta go back. We don't attack this explosive mine, by the way. Don't attack it, I'm telling you. Don't attack it, guys. Very important, it's not attacked. We gotta keep making more Rohirrim Arches in the meantime. Aragorn! But it was close. Use heal as well. Let them come. Be ready. See if your ally. Aragorn, peel back. Well. Which way? Right there. So, okay, we are good now. Aragorn is quite tanky. Atelas is on cooldown, so we can put Aragorn maybe. No, we can put him behind. Kill this Berserkers, please. They deal way too much damage. Can we defend this area, though? That's the question. That's the big question, you know? Gimli is tanky, but is he tanky enough? Use Leap Attack, Gimli. Slayer is almost back up. Let's right-click on Slayer so he can use it whenever he needs to. Legolas, we can put him inside the Titter. This way he's gonna be in a safe spot, at least. There we go. Slayer is available, and Aragorn is gonna be in a safe spot. But during all this time, we are losing this piece. We gotta summon this. Eomer and Theoden are back in the business, but we have no units. Did we not make any more units? The answer is no, we didn't make any more units, unfortunately. But we are able to hold the line, okay? We are able to hold the gate. We can use Cloudbreak maybe to stun the enemy units, but there are even level 5 units, Legolas, everyone. I think we're gonna lose this base, unfortunately, guys. It is how it is. Okay, I mean, I don't know what to say. I know what to do. We gotta make triple stable, just to be able to get the units faster on the field. This guy is face tanking still. Let's deal with that. Legolas is one-shotting everybody from this. But I cannot believe that. They are losing the base. And that's a scary army there. Moving now to our side. This is so tough. Did he use Atelas? No, he didn't use Atelas. We can now get Legolas back from this. I'm sure that we have to keep this one alive. That's the main thing. We need to keep this alive no matter what, okay? For that reason, we need to use Death and Glory. Glorious Charge it is. And just trample them to death, shall we? Just to trample them to death. Don't want to kill them slowly but surely. That's the power of Glorious Charge. We can trample them without getting slowed down. Aragorn is tanky. We can use AOD now. Atelas. I mean, Blade Master, go inside. Okay. We are safe, I believe. And send him forward right there. We have Atelas available, so I'm not too much. Oh, I made a mistake. Oh, Gimli. Gimli, no way. Oh, he used AOD, that's why. He used AOD, that's why. We gotta keep. Oh, man. Oh, I'm falling apart. I'm falling apart. Aragorn can kill AOD, but yes, yeah, lost everything again. This AOD summon from the Heart Army is just broken. It's just too much to handle. Just too much to handle, guys. Not gonna lie. This is just too much to handle. Heal up. Destroy this base. If we lose this base, that would be horrible. I mean, that would be literally horrible. And I believe the Isengard, how many did we defeat so far? Two. Still six to go. I cannot believe that. We need to use EOD here, guys. It is how it is, unfortunately. Let's move downstairs then. Cam? Do we have leadership rights now? I don't know, there's still one Isengard in the game. There is still one Isengard in the game. And look at this guy. Before he's building anything else. Oh, there is a mine. Look at this now. Boom. I beat you with your own weapons. Just like that, alright? We can use King's Favor to give them experience, shall we? Okay, buy this piece. Beautiful. EOD was doing a nice job, but it's gonna be on a huge, huge cooldown. We gotta wait for the Monster Trio to come back to the game. And, yeah. Alright, so let's go like this, shall we? There is Gimli, who's very tanky, trying to kill our bees. Let's destroy this one. I think we need to destroy this Rohan outpost at the bottom side as well. So let's make statues here in the front side and wells in the back side. Even though we need also some money though. We need some money. There is Legolas also on the field. Kill this end, please. Very important. We can kill this one. Okay. Alright, so the good thing is we are getting money from Eomer, you know, that's good. Okay, Legolas is back, Aragorn is back, and Gimli once again is taking more time to join the battlefield once again. Legolas is outranging our towers. Let's put them next to the statues so they have more damage leadership. Buy this if we can, and then just heal up a little bit at the well before we move on. We are waiting for Gimli to come back, and we should be abusing the fact that Boromir is gonna die in a second. Abusing the fact that AOD from our opponent is on cooldown. So we lost one of the stables, but it is how it is. Do I really need to come back there? Oh no, we can actually try to, you know, deal with that now. And there is Legolas. He's gonna die in a second. 90 gold only for killing Legolas. We need to now keep moving forward. We gotta defeat this. Oh, eagles. They are getting one-shotted, luckily, like you can see. Glorious charge? Don't die, Theoden, I'm telling you. You die now, it's over. Oof. Yeah. Aragorn, Gimli, Legolas. Side by side. You move to the mortar base, please. Okay, we're gonna use Ensam and we're gonna fully commit now with Cloudbreak and everything against this Rohan. Kill the Sitter with the Ents, and then we're gonna focus down the buildings with the Rohirrim marches on the other side. Okay? This is the plan. And we were able to deal with Gimli, finally. We can use AOD here, and then use Blade Master. Send him to Sitter. Okay. Kill this units. Kill the Sitter so he's not be able to make any more buildings. Kill the level 3 buildings right after. Oh, there is Treebeard, so we need to kill him. Kill this soon. Oh, we forgot to make towers, yeah. That's unlucky. Okay, we killed the Sitter finally. Now we can use this to kill. What? We one-shotted our Theoden. Just like that. We need to make Theoden from this one actually. And Aragorn died also. How did Aragorn die? I cannot understand that. Run for your life, Legolas. And Gimli, you was not supporting them for whatever reason. You don't deserve to live, but it is how it is. We need to make Aragorn back, make a well here, so our heroes are able to sustain faster. And this is so tough. This is so unbelievably tough. I mean, you probably watched the 1v7 on Old Brownlands, guys, right? But this is, like, next level, pretty much. Kill this, please. Level 10, can we save him? The answer is yes, we can save him. We were able to defeat the space, that's all that matters. We can now send our units back. He's using Slayer. He's outrunning our horses. This is unbelievable. Run from this dude. Okay, Legolas is still alive. We are waiting for the wells to come up. And we can now... Oh, that is Gandalf the White. Gimli against Gandalf the White. Look, Gimli damage against Gandalf. Do you see that? He's using the shield bubble. Alright. Gimli is victorious. We are waiting for Theoden and Aragorn. Aragorn is gonna be back very soon. We were able to defend ourselves. We're gonna wait for Aragorn. Kill Gimli, not a big deal. With this much leadership, we have also statue leadership, of course, which means 100% more damage. Okay, kill this Ent, the last march of the Ents. Look how fast they're gonna die, guys, please, watch. One-shotted. Not even Theoden, but Theoden is back in the business and Aragorn is also back in the business, that's quite nice. Now, the monster trio can now move once again to this side, and we can actually, we destroyed this base, right? Yeah, we destroyed this base. We have also rangers now we need to deal with. Let's use Glorious Charge here, shall we? Okay, let's go like this. Destroy this Gondor outpost, maybe. There is a Legolas also. They will regret this day. Look, this Legolas. Nope, Legolas. Oh, Legolas is strong. Oh! What is this? What are my Rohirrim archers doing? I don't understand. They are diving in too deep. I'm gonna commit fully against this piece. I have Atelas for Aragorn, so I'm not too much worried about this. Where is Legolas at? Legolas is here doing nothing. Sounds good. Kill this catapult, please. Aragorn, you kill the siege works, my friend. And we were able to destroy this outpost finally. That's good. Pretty good, actually. Gimli is kind of face tanking too many units, so we need to disengage with Gimli, run for our lives. Aragorn can use Atelas now, it's the perfect time. And we buy this base, I mean this outpost, shall we? There we go. Now we can also bring in some more Rohirrim archers to this side. Support them. Make a well, double well here in the backside and a statue in the front side. Okay, that's what we're gonna build here at this outpost. So we have sustain and leadership support. Use Elven Wood to cover this Elven Wood from our opponent. Careful against tower guards, kill them first before they kill Rohirrim archers in a second. Aragorn! And we were not even able to finish off this base. And also Legolas died. Oh, guys, it's so hard to watch everything, you know, at the same time, sometimes. Are we gonna commit against this base with the Rohirrim, shall we? We also lost this outpost, by the way. And we are losing this base at the same time. Yes, though. Fiesta. Kill these eagles, please. Kill these eagles! Stop dodging. Cloudbreak is being used now from our opponent. Bring them to the well so they can sustain. Look how many units he has. That's unbelievable. Use Glorious Charge. Gimli, please do something. Your base is getting attacked, Gimli. Don't sleep. Use Cloudbreak to stun the enemy units. We should be able to save this outpost, hopefully. Need to kill these Ents first and tribute, pretty important. Okay, now we can just keep fighting normally. Oh, he killed our citadel. Is this a normal Ent? Yeah, it's a normal Ent, so we need to manually kill him. He's not gonna disappear automatically. Kill these buildings, please. Oh, but look, his ally is protecting him very nicely, you know? Oh boy, I don't know what to say. Theoden! Oh no, man. It's Aragorn. And also Eomer died. I cannot believe it. I cannot believe it. Okay, there we go. Please, 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 please. Okay, we have some Rohirrim matches still left, so we need to kill this Ent now. Very important. Way we can potentially be able to save the space. What an insane game, dude. What an insane game. Trio is back in the business. Kill the buildings, please. Oh, but they didn't kill the city yet? How? That is also weak. I don't understand. Trample. There we go. Okay, let's make some towers here, shall we? Alright, so Aragorn. We need to keep an eye. I mean, I'm kind of playing lazy a little bit, not gonna lie. Gimli, you Slayer, you kill this tower. And Legolas, you kill all the units. Help them, Rohirrim. Please, get more Rohirrim archers on the field. Very important. Oh, there is Gandalf on foot. We are waiting for our heroes to join the battlefield once again. Let's go like this. Aragorn, kill this last remaining tower, please. And we are good to go. Where is Legolas at? Why is Legolas attacking this mill? I don't understand that. Okay, Hart army has been defeated. Whew, that was close. That was cruel close. And now we have only 5 more to go. 5 more to go. Kill this Gandalf, please. Okay, kill this units around this side. Bring Legolas in here as well. Make towers, very important. Keep those towers around the base so we have at least some sort of protection. And now we can use the AOD once again. And kill this outpost, shall we? And Gimli can use... His Slayer is on cooldown still. Okay, let's go like that. Actually, we can make double well here. So we have some sustain. We have heal and Atela's ability available. So I'm not too worried about this situation. But I'm worried about this situation. Okay, kill this. Nice. Make double well here for the sustain. Tower is towering up. And there is also Rohan outpost right there. So make farms here, just why not? And make some more units around this side as well.
I'm wounded! Aragorn!
Kill this tribute, please. There we go. Nice. Aragorn! How did I lose? Oh, AOD summon once again. Are you kidding me, man? Are you kidding me? Lost. Oh, we have no money. I cannot believe it.
Let us hunt some orc.
We will have victory.
Rohirrim, we return.
Right. We cannot even revive somebody, right? We couldn't revive Aragorn, but now we have the money to revive him. Oh, this summons are crazy from Gondor, though. We gotta use AOD here for defense. We don't lose the base right after we buy it. And make us lose so much money as well, you know? And now with Eomer, we should be able to get some money back. Perfect timing for the AOD to deal with the ants as well. Let's buy this farm. Let's go to this outpost, destroy this outpost. What is left is level 1 or level 3 farm in this case. Heal up with the units, very important. Our Rohirrim marches are quite badly damaged, but now they should be fine. We destroyed this outpost, nice. Maybe we have time to kill this ants as well. That would be awesome if we could. Let's see. And yes, we could do that. That's quite nice. I like it. Okay. What's the plan now? The plan is now make towers here. First of all, that's the first thing what we need to do. We can also try to destroy this outpost right there. And bring in the Rohirrim archers to this side, shall we? So we have more Rohirrim archers around this area, which is nice. Kill this if we can. And this guy keeps sending more. I know what I'm supposed to do. So I will definitely need a Rohirrim archer around this side. Is this a Legolas from me? Yeah, it's a Legolas from me. I was like, what is Legolas doing there? I'm curious, guys. I've never seen this. Oh, he's gonna try to kill my Legolas. No. I'm curious about this damage. Let's see. Not bad, but it could be much, much better, of course. Aragorn is back in the business as well. Okay. And where is the second Rohirrim archer? There he is. Nice. Let's go like this. Okay. So, use the monster trio. No, this is not the monster trio. We are waiting for Gimli still. We're gonna use the Rohirrim archers to attack this base from Rohan. Our base is still in a not bad spot. And we're gonna use the monster trio to move downstairs to this base. So, for death and glory, there we go. Use Elven Wood as well, so we have some more resistance. We don't get one-shotted from these towers in long terms. Okay. I didn't use Glorious Charge. I didn't. Okay, now I'm gonna do it. Kill its hitter first. Don't lose Eomer. Don't lose Eomer. Kill its towers. They're focusing my area for some reason. We have some rangers behind us, so we need to kill the rangers first of all. In the meantime, our monster trio... Oh, this base is destroyed already, right? Yeah. Put his guns up. Now you see him, now you don't. Look how fast he's gonna go down. Plus 300 for killing Gandalf. I was expecting more, to be honest. Where's Aragorn at? Aragorn, you need to help your ally, my friend. Because Legolas is gonna need 1 hour to kill these ants. But Aragorn is gonna two-shot them. Look, look, Aragorn's damage against these ants. This is crazy damage. Okay. They are also dealing a lot of damage to Aragorn, but it's just not enough, you know? It's not enough. Okay. We will need to summon the Elven allies around this area to kill these trebuchets. Theoden has to be careful, though. I don't know why he's face tanking everything. Let's be careful with Theoden. Use Glorious Charge here, shall we? Where are our Rohan heroes? There they are. Nice. So we can buy this base. Kill these units. Make towers around this base as well. Once again, it's quite important. So we have some protection at least. Make well, well, well. Well, well, well. My mistake. I was not paying attention. You need to always use the rocks with this. No, this guy's kind of tanking so much damage. I was shooting at him. I don't know. Use Attilas. Kill this mine, shall we? And kill this output right after. Very important. Okay. So we gotta actually now, guys. Oh, there is AOD summon. We actually gotta do now. Wait a second. We're gonna use Glorious Charge to kill these units faster. We make a statue here. Aragorn is moving forward. Legolas should be killing these eagles, no big deal. Aragorn and Gimli can take down this. Eagle is actually quite resistant against Legolas. I was expecting him to deal way more damage than he actually does. Okay, we need to be careful. This tree bit is going down. Heal up a little bit with the Eomir. Use Anduril's Sword. Blade Master, I mean. And use AOD as well. There we go. And use Slayer with Gimli to increase our DPS. Okay. I think we are in a good spot right now. If we kill this outpost, of course. Which we should be able to do. Kill this. We were also able to destroy this outpost with our Rohirrim, which is quite nice. Now we can also go to this site and actually sandwich. One Heart army has been defeated as well, that's quite nice. I don't know, maybe it was the last outpost from him at the bottom right side. Maybe this was the reason why he was alive. But anyways, he got defeated. So now, we lose Theoden. No, he's inside the city, that's why I was for a second worried that we lost Theoden. Now we're gonna sandwich the space from both the sides, as you can see. With the normal Rohirrim from the one side and Rohirrim archers and heroes from the other side. This base, I think it's gonna be hard to protect, but it is how it is. I don't mind losing this one. As long as we keep moving and making progress. And let's move to this side with the heroes, shall we? Let's go like this. Legolas needs to be careful to not... Oh, look how many. Holy guacamole. Alright, alright, alright. You are the boss. The baristas, though. The baristas, though. And Eomer. Eomer. Be careful, Eomer. Alright, Aragorn is still alive. Gimli Slayer, kill the ballistas, please. Look, Gimli's damage, that's crazy. Alright, our Eomer was able to survive, that's the main thing, very important. Oh, there is some explosive mind action coming on, going on. I mean, we can kill these ants the second they get spawned. Look, there are three of them are already dead, guys, just like that. Now, I just want to finish off this base really fast. Gimli! Does Aragorn have Anduril? Gimli, put him inside, please, 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 please. He was able to survive. That's good, I like it. He was able to survive. Alright, kill the towers, please. Focus down the buildings only. Ignore the units. But it's so much harder though. So much harder. I cannot believe what is going on here. Is he defeated now? Yes, he is defeated now. That's huge. That's huge and great. I like it. Okay. Aragorn can use Blademaster and Eori at the same time, so he should be fine. He can make a well here behind to regenerate with Gimli over time. Legolas is also pretty low. Oh, Gimli died actually. I thought I put him inside the Citadel. No, he was dead, dude. Are you kidding me? That's so unlucky. That's so unlucky. Okay, we need to make a well here, guys. Very important. Oh, our Rohirrim archers, though, are dying. Okay, let's put this guy here. We have lots of units around this side as well, so we should be fine. And let's group them all together around this side. Make towers here. I mean, we have not seen Balrog summon from the opening just yet. But other than that, we have seen pretty much everything. So we can make towers here once again to save the space as well. Just why not? We lost the Citta, but we have Elven Allies back up, so we can maybe use Elven Allies here and try to protect ourselves against this trebuchet, shall we? Yeah. Uh-oh. And we had to use EOD here to not lose all of our units. Okay. Keep moving forward with EOD to the Gondor base, shall we? Buy the space outpost back, I mean. Alright, next thing what we need to destroy. Oh, he used AOD on us? Yes, he used AOD on us. We lost everything. We lost everything, guys. Okay, lost everything. We're gonna lose his outpost, unfortunately. But it is how it is. Okay. Faramir, slowly but surely. Oh, this game is intense, dude. This game is seriously intense. It was kind of hard. Really, I didn't expect... I mean, I know it's hard to play against 7 hard armies, but I was not expecting it to be that hard. I think this is also the longest one. We are still not done yet, so... I don't know what to say. Get to this outpost here. Well, stage one. Okay, let's go like this. There is Aragorn died too. Eagles coming in clutch. Did we forget to make towers here? Maybe we did, I don't know. Legolas is inside the tower, so we have some defense around this side at least. Make towers, make towers, make towers. Gimli is back in the business first. Fine with that. Hopefully he's not gonna kill our Citta. How long are these eagles are lasting for? Kill those lords. Go for a leap attack first. Kaboom! Okay. Kill Saruman first and lords next. Use Cloudbreak, shall we? The space is in a safe spot right now, so we can make towers maybe. Cloudbreak is able to stun the enemy units, as you can see. Look, Gimli's damage. Crazy, right? Okay, now we need to peel back. Oh, we didn't revive Aragorn? What? We have no money then. I will ride. We have no money. We need Aragorn back, though. We need Aragorn back as soon as we possibly can. Do we have the money now for Aragorn? Yes, but we have no command points. Aragorn costs command points, if you don't know. Same with... Let's kill this, please. Why are they scared? I don't understand. They are level 2. Level 2 doesn't normally stun the units in BFME1 with the Cloudbreak. Okay, so, I mean, now is the time Gimli has been taken down. Now is the time for us to shine. Oh, there is Gandalf with the lightning sword. I see you, Gandalf the White. Gimli has been taken down. It is how it is, so we can make Gimli back. Legolas might be in trouble as well. Okay, now we need to go to the space. Now we need to just go to the space. Really, we have no time to waste. There's one more Isengard, of course, as you can see, the Ents are going to war against Isengard. Legolas has to run for his life. Hopefully he will get away. Oh, no, he won't. Oh, the entrance of the space is actually further behind. Do we have Glorious Charge? It's on cooldown. Because he doesn't have Cloudbreak though, which is not bad for us. Use the Alvin Wood right there. We can fight here, I believe. Kinda. We need to kill the Citadel, very important. Get Legolas back on the field as well. We lost this outpost. Unfortunately, but it is how it is. We can now... Oh, the ants are doing nothing. Okay, I see you, ants. But we can maybe kill... with the Elven allies. Would be nice if we could. Please go inside there, maybe. Or the trebuchet, or... Oh, this is a nightmare, dude. This is a nightmare. Okay, we also need normal Rohirrim, I believe. So heal up here. Important. Aragorn is back in the, on the field, which is good. Aragorn, it's one man army. We need him. And this base is kind of asleep still. Okay, we have... a big army now.
Onward. Rohan must stand.
Battle awaits. Riders of the mark.
Oh, be careful with the heroes.
A darkness covers our lands.
Keep these lands safe. The enemy is here.
Oh, we might use heal on our heroes. There we go. Use glorious charge. For death and glory. And go inside the jeans. Kill this trebuchet first. Oh, this lord. So he pins and killed my Eomer. This is so unlucky. We lost now a really important chunk of leadership. Just like that. We gotta kill this tower guards, guys. Very important to kill them very fast. Otherwise, we're gonna lose every single of our Rohirrim archer in seconds. Okay, go for a trample. Ignore everything, guys. And just kill the building, shall we? Put the archer range first. Aragorn, Legolas. Bills are here as well. Which is really annoying. Kill the well. Kill the barracks right after.
You have my blessing, friends of Rohan. This will be a day to remember.
I'm gonna use AOD here. Just you know, to be able to make sure that we are able to destroy this base. Oh, Eomer died before, yeah. And I forgot. Lourdes was able to kill him, remember? Okay. Yeah. I think this is also from Gondor, right? So we need to destroy this outpost as well to defeat him. Match. Okay, but we were able to defeat his castle, which is good. We can now just move on to this outpost and also take it down. Would be quite good if we could. And also group all the units here. The trio, the monster trio. Kill these buildings if we can. One of Gondor doesn't help you, my friend. Use Glorious Charge to make sure everything is getting killed a little bit faster. Glorious Charge doesn't only give you armor, it also gives you 30% damage, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 30% more damage, which is very good. Kill the barracks. We're gonna buy this base here with Tyrion, by the way. That's why I'm going back. Kill this outpost right after. There we go. And now we can also keep making more units, maybe. We have enough money now, which is quite... No, yeah, which is quite... What? We buy the base, okay. I'm kinda confused, it's... kinda exhausting game, guys, not gonna lie. Farms. Okay. And the outpost got destroyed. I think with that also the Gonzo player himself, right? The Heart Army has been defeated. That's gonna leave only one person alive. I mean... can you imagine, we are gonna try this eventually with Isengard and Mordor and stuff like this. Rohan is not good because of the mobility, so we are mobile units or heroes, you know. And you have strong heroes like Aragorn, Gimli, Legolas, who can take down an entire side all alone. But imagine that you try that with Isengard, I think it's gonna be really challenging. Okay, let's heal up a little bit, then we are good to go. And we can group this trio to move them to this side. I believe that this is Mordor, right? Yeah, this is, looks like Mordor to me. I might be wrong, though. Oh! Alright, I see you, Balrog. I see you. Okay, this is actually interesting. I like that, because they are using now AOD, Balrog, everything. Even though he's Balrog summon, maybe he needs to watch a tutorial of Shanks. Maybe you need to watch a tutorial about how to use Balrog, my friend. That's not the way you want to do it. He's still using the breath fire. Gimli! Oh, it was not on point to heal up. Blade Master. I'm gonna use heal first and I use this. This Ballistas are dealing so much damage. It's kind of annoying, you know? Okay, it's Isengard we are facing against. It's not Mordor. It's the last remaining Isengard. Get ready. Kill this, please. Okay. He's using also rain, by the way. So we have no leadership rights now on our Rohirrim marches, which is kind of unfortunate. But it is how it is. We can use Glorious Judge for death and glory and write them down, shall we? Write them down. One shot everybody. Kill the spikes. Before we do anything else, we get so much money from him. I believe, I wish there would be a statistic, guys, which would show us how much money we could make in the entire game, or we did make in the entire game from a level 2 upgrade, a level 2 ability from Eomer, you know? It would be amazing. Need to be careful with Eomer. He's still face tanking these towers for some reason. Yeah, there we go. Now he should not be tanking anymore this damage, so we should be fine. And Aragorn was or will be able to destroy this one, not a big deal. Blue arrows. And I think that's it, right? I don't think he has anything left anymore, if I'm not mistaken. And we should be finally able to win this one. I don't know, guys. It was really, really challenging. I cannot even... What? Maybe I was excited a little bit too early, because he's not defeated yet. Okay. Maybe he was buying this outpost? I'm not sure. Oh, this outpost is not destroyed yet. That's why he's not defeated. Okay. Use Army of the Dead for the last. And we are victorious. Oh, God. This was tough, man. But we did it. We played 1 versus 7 against 7 hard PCs, 7 hard armies in BFME1 on the patch 1.06 on the map Rune. We played Rohan. We didn't have a castle. We had only a camp. We survived with heroes all alone for the first 10 to 15 minutes. We had to deal with multiple Gondors, Rohans, Isengard, Mordors. We had to deal with Army of the Dead summon, Eagle summon, Rohan allies summon. It was quite tough, but we made it work. Thank you guys so much for watching. If this was enjoyable for you, it was kind of tough for me, but hopefully it was enjoyable for you. So you can leave a like on this video and subscribe for more content like this. Take care of yourselves. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace, guys.